Hey everybody, in this example video, we're going to be solving for the Lewis structure of O3, which is ozone. To easily remember the steps for finding a Lewis structure, I have them in the top right hand corner of our screens now. So let's get right into this problem. First, we need to find the total number of valence electrons that are present within our compound. So remember our trick to easily remember how many valence electrons an atom in groups 1A to 7A has. We look at the group number, the column that our atom resides in, and that'll tell us the number of valence electrons that atom will have in its neutral state. Therefore, oxygen, being in group 6A, will have 6 valence electrons. And as a whole, our compound in total will have 18 valence electrons. Next, we need to find what is going to be our central atom. Well, in this particular example, we just have 3 identical atoms. Therefore, selecting a central atom is trivial and is completed for us. Now, we need to create a skeletal structure for our compound. So, let's place any one of our oxygen atoms as our central atom, and place the other 2 oxygen atoms around the central one. Then let's add in our valence electrons and create our skeletal structure. However, this doesn't really work as we have 2 single electrons on either side of our central oxygen atom. So, what do we do here? Well, instead of our central oxygen atom having 2 lone pairs of electrons, maybe it'll form a double bond with either of the oxygens on the left or right. So let's recreate our Lewis structure and first fill out our outer oxygen octets like so. Then let's see where we land in the validation stages, in which we check if our total number of valence electrons matches step 1, and that all atoms that are needed are satisfied in terms of the octet rule. So counting our valence electrons, we have 8 valence electrons in our left and right oxygens, but only 6 in our central oxygen. Therefore, its octet is not filled. And as you can see here, we have already used our available 18 valence electrons. So, what can ozone do to better stabilize itself? Well, there are 2 scenarios. Either the left or the right oxygen will give up a lone pair of electrons and share them with the central atom, thus stabilizing and validating our Lewis structure. This is what we call a resonance structure, as both of these Lewis structures are equally valid, and we will be talking more about resonance structures in the coming videos. Lastly, ozone takes on the molecular geometry of bent, just like we saw in our previous example on a video of water. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.